今天早晨呢，我们特别邀请到尼寇牧师，跟我们继续有主日的分享。
And so this morning, we've invited Pastor Nicole to give us her testimony and sharing on the Sunday service.
尼寇牧师跟我一样，我们都从台湾长大，从台湾然后到美国来的。
Pastor Nicole has a similar background as myself, since we are both from Taiwan. We both grew up in Taiwan.
尼寇牧师，事实上我认识他不是太久啊，我是2017年才认识他的。
In fact, I've only known Pastor Nicole since 2017, so not for a very long time.
但尼寇实在是一个非常非常特别的姐妹啊，特别的传道人。
But indeed, Pastor Nicole is a very special sister and a very unique pastor.
小红牧师跟我呢，我们都非常爱她。
And both Pastor Ruth and myself, we love her very much.
因为每一次见到她呢，都好像对我们来说是人生的一个季节的转变。
And every time we see her, it seems as if we are at a turning point, a season of turning in our lives.
我想我们在前面已经分享过，所以今天早晨我们特别尊荣，也欢迎有尼寇牧师能够来到我们的当中啊。他现在在线上啊，他今天我们的主日的信息呢，是从线上翻到线下啊。
And so we've invited Pastor Nicole to join us this morning. She is online, and so her message will be broadcast from online in Zoom and will be provided translation.
好，是不是我们一起也可以用掌声哈，欢迎尼寇牧师，好不好？
Let's give a round of applause to welcome her.
尼寇，可不可以打开你的视频？好。
好。
我们把时间交给尼寇啊。
And we'll turn our time over to Pastor Nicole now.
谢谢陈牧师
yeah. Thank you, Pastor Chen.
今天真的很荣幸可以到，没有 physically， 早知道就 physically 来到 Austin.
Today I'm very honored to be able to join you. Had I known in advance, I would have made arrangements to be in physically in Austin.
期待很快能够 physically 来到 Austin.
And I hope and anticipate that I will be able to do that soon.
那我相信在线上也很好。
But of course, I believe that having this gathering online is very good as well.
Yeah, 谢谢陈牧师跟小红牧师的邀请。
And so I thank Pastor Chen and Pastor Ruth for their invitation.
那我们这一次整个的这个聚集。
And so this gathering.
我们的名字就是刚刚这个theme 呢，就是刚刚陈牧师的介绍。
The theme, as was introduced by Pastor Chen.
那当我张成牧师跟我说来分享这个主日信息的时候
，And so when Pastor Chen asked me to share on the Sunday morning,
好像是一个傍晚的时候知道他要我分享，然后我就睡了一觉，隔天早上起来我就给他一个题目。
And so he extended the invitation to me on a particular evening, and then I slept on it, and then the day after I gave him sort of a topic.
Yeah, 那这个题目叫做震动进入弥赛亚国度的摇篮。
And so my topic for him was in the midst of shaking, entering into the crib of the Messiah.
Hi, Jake, you still there?
Yeah, it was stuck for a little bit. Go ahead.
Okay. So you're done with the translation, right?
Yeah, sorry, it was shaking in the midst of shaking, entering into the crib of the Messiah.
Messiah kingdom, very good, thank you. 那我觉得要思考这个主题之前呢，我觉得有一个事情，好像因为我们的确是活在一个很大的一个震动的一个环境跟一个时代里面。
But before we can consider this topic, we have to realize and reflect on this fact, which is that we are indeed living in an era in which there is great shaking indeed.
那我要带大家进入一个思考，就是你知道我们的思想会非常严重的来影响到我们的行为。
And so, our thoughts greatly influence and affect our behavior. And so this is the kind of the point of reflection I want to bring everyone into.
所以换句话说，你对一件事情的感官或者是看法会影响到你怎么感觉，或者是说怎么有怎么样的回应。
which is that, in other words, your perspective and your perception towards a certain event or towards a thing greatly affects how you respond or react to that event or thing.
Good job, Jack. Thank you. 那我自己感觉呢，其实我们每一个人的里面都有一个 paradigm， 都有一个思考模式。
And so my thought on this is that every one of us within ourselves, we have a paradigm, a way of thinking.
我们这个思考模式呢，我们就用这个思考模式来过生活。
And this paradigm structure is the one in which we live our everyday lives.
我们这个思考模式影响我们怎么感受这个世界。
And this paradigm affects how we perceive this world.
我们这个思考模式也会影响我们怎么样活出来。
And of course, this paradigm, this way of thinking affects how we live our lives out.
那我刚刚陈牧师的介绍就从2020年这个 pandemic进入到人类的历史当中之后呢，很多的事情都改变了。
And so as Pastor Chen introduced earlier, ever since in 2020, the pandemic has entered into our human history, human world, everything, a lot of things have changed.
所有的我们一般生活的正常的作息里面，很多的东西都改变了。
A lot of things about our daily schedule, how we arrange our daily lives have been changed and affected.
我们的旅行改变了。
Our travel has been affected.
我们的聚会模式改变了。
The way we have gatherings have changed.
我们的 shopping 怎么样买东西改变了。
And how we buy things, how we shop has changed.
我们吃饭可能也改变了。
In fact, how we eat and have meals probably have changed as well.
最近不怎么去了。
And perhaps you used to like going out to restaurants and you're not able to anymore.
那我们上课的方式改变了。
The way we go to classes, go to school have changed.
我们娱乐的方式改变了。
The way we have our entertainment has changed.
我听到很多的家长有特别有小小孩的，因为不敢出去，所以这个就关在家里面，整个生活的娱乐的方式全都改变了。
And so a lot of parents with younger children are afraid to take them out to places to play. So the way we entertain ourselves, entertain our children being stuck at home is changed.
Yeah, 可能甚至我们的运动方式改变了。
And in fact, the way we exercise andhas changed.
所以你如果去思考这么多层面的改变，
So if you consider all of these aspects and layers of changes,
换句话说，我们原本的思考模式，我们原本的行为模式被很大的震动。
In other words, our paradigm, our way of thinking, our way of behavior has been shaken greatly.
大部分的人没有办法按照原本的 paradigm 或者是思考模式、行为模式去继续生活。
Most people will not be able to continue to live their daily lives in accordance to the original paradigm of way of thinking and way of behavior.
那当我们的这个 paradigm 或者是我们的这个思考模式这么大的被改变的时候，
And so when our way of thinking and paradigm has been changed and modified so greatly,
有的时候这些改变对有一些人或许很容易。
Sometimes it's easier for some people.
但是对有一些人可能会做很困难的调整。
But for others, to make these adjustments would be a lot more difficult.
也对很多数的人来说，可能就 get stuck, 就卡住了。
And for a lot of people, perhaps, they feel like they're getting stuck.
我昨天第一个晚上我听到 Bill 讲说，因为疫情的关系，他前三个月都不出门。
The first evening, I heard Brother Bill share that for the first 3 months of the pandemic, he didn't dare go out his door at all.
我相信这个也是有史以来他没有经历过的这个改变。
And I trust that that was a change that he had never experienced before.
你知道，大部分的人就是因为被卡住了，所以因为怕病毒、怕染疫的关系，进入了孤独，进入了隔离，那结果就是沮丧。
And so the ending result being depression comes from the fact that people feel like they are stuck, they are lonely, and they don't want to be infected and don't want to catch the virus.
Yeah, 那结果呢？就这个这些结果就是沮丧。
And so the ending result is depression, frustration.
所以我们如果来思考这整个发生的事情的时候，
And so if we consider this whole event and how it occurred,
我觉得有一个很重要的就是 我们需要帮助我们自己，也需要帮助周围的弟兄姐妹，怎么样从那个卡住的情况把它拔出来。
And so one very important thing I think we need to learn is how to help ourselves and the brothers and sisters around us to unstuck ourselves, to lift ourselves from being stuck.
Yeah, 那我觉得有一个很重要的就是说我们可能要有一个所谓的 paradigm shift, 就是整个我们的模式的一个改变。
And so I think our mode of thinking, our paradigm, very importantly, needs to have a shift, a paradigm shift.
那 我就在思考说，那怎么样帮助弟兄姐妹有这个所谓的 paradigm shift, 这个整个模式的改变呢？
And so I've been reflecting on how I can help my brothers and sisters to achieve that paradigm shift.
那这个对的模式，或者是说在这个时代我们应该有的这个 paradigm 应该在哪里找啊？
And how do we find the right paradigm to follow in this day and age?
那我正确答案，主日学的小朋友都知道，正确答案一定在圣经里面。
And as every Sunday school children will know, the right answer is always the Bible. It's in the Bible.
我就去思考，你知道，在圣经里面呢，其实我们的确有看到整个，我要特别讲的是，救恩的历史来看，人类历史当中的确有很多次的所谓的巨大的变化。
So if we look at the whole history of the gospel and the whole history of mankind, indeed, there has been plenty of occasion on which there were great changes looking at the Bible.
Yeah, 我特别要强调的是救恩的历史。
And I want to place this emphasis indeed on the gospel's history, the history of the gospel, the salvation.
跟救恩有关系的。
And all things that relate to the salvation.
因为环境的动荡很多。
Because environmental changes and shakings, there's plenty of those.
Yeah, 但是我要说的是，整个圣经里面看到救恩的历史所带出来的动荡。
But I want to kind of emphasize on the shakings that were brought about through the history of salvation.
那我第一个想到的呢，就是摩西的时代。
And so the first era that we reflect upon is the time of Moses.
你知道在整个以色列百姓啊，希伯来的 这群人呢，其实是神所拣选的百姓。
And you know, the people of the Israelites, the Hebrews, was this chosen people by God.
那他们呢，后来因为我想大家熟悉这个创世纪的这个故事，那后来呢，因为饥荒的关系，他们就整族人这个雅各的这十二个儿子全部都跑到埃及去了。
And you are all familiar with the story in Genesis, due to a great famine, Jacob and his 12 sons eventually all went to Egypt.
但是这一群人是神所拣选的，那是要带出救恩计划的，不能卡在埃及啊。
But this group of people were the elect by God, and they cannot be stuck in Egypt.
所以就在这个时代。
So in that time, in that era,
因为神要释放出他的救恩的下一页。
In order for God to release the next page of his plan of salvation,
所以他兴起一个很重要的人叫做摩西。
He raised up a very important character by the name of Moses. Sorry, yeah, the internet stuck for a little bit. He raised up a very important character by the name of Moses.
Thank you. 那他把这个摩西，就是说摩西，你如果仔细去看哦，摩西是一个很重要的，在救恩历史当中一个很重要的一个角色。
So if you look at the character of Moses very carefully, he was a very important character in the history of salvation, God's salvation.
那摩西出生的时候呢，发生了一件事情。
And when Moses was born, a great event had occurred.
所有的希伯来男婴全部都被杀了。
All of the baby boys, the Hebrew baby boys were killed.
你记得这个历史背景，我就不多去讲这些故事的细节。
And so I won't go into the details of the story since everyone is familiar.
因为一个救恩要发生了，但是这整个在当时的这个世代里面，你可以想象，你如果你在当时的环境里面，所有你周围只要有生男孩的，全部都被杀了。
So if you imagine yourselves in that time, in that place, everyone around you, including yourself, if you had a baby boy, they were all killed.
我相信对整个以色列或者是希伯来人是非常大的震动。
And I think that would have been a very great shaking for the Hebrews of the time.
我相信对埃及人也是很大的震动。
I think it would have been a very great shaking for the Egyptians at the time as well.
为什么会有这样的一个可怕的事情发生呢？
Why did this dreadful event occur?
因为仇敌知道救恩要进一步了。
Because the enemy knew that the gospel of God, God's salvation, was about to take one step in advance. Because salvation was about to be released out of the Hebrews.
那你如果再看下，我再就会想到另外一个救恩的历史，有很多很多的转折点。另外一个最大的转折点，我就举这两个例子。另外一个最大的转折点就是耶稣降生的时候。
And so the second example of a turning point in the history of God's salvation is, of course, the birth and the coming of Jesus Christ.
那没有 no doubt 的，就是没有怀疑的，就是我们知道救恩历整个救恩历史里面，耶稣是最重要的主角。
And of course, without a doubt, we know that Jesus is the pinnacle, the most important character, the main character of the history of salvation.
耶稣如果没有诞生的话，我们今天都不会在这里，我们都不会得救。
If Jesus had not been born, we wouldn't be here. We would not be saved.
但是我们如果回想到耶稣诞生的那个时代
，But if we reflect upon the times during which Jesus was born,
又是一个极大的震动跟哀嚎。
Again, it was a great wailing and a great shaking.
当希律王知道说有一个犹大的王要出生的时候，他就屠杀了当时所有两岁以下的男孩。
When Herod heard of the fact that a king of the Jews was about to be born, he killed off all of the boys who were under 2 years of age.
为什么呢？
Why?
因为仇敌知道这个全世界的救主正要被诞生了。
Again, the enemy knew that the savior of the whole world was about to be born.
但我刚刚讲说耶稣的诞生是人类历史最重要的一个 mark。
The birth of Jesus Christ was the most important mark in the human history.
耶稣第一次来的时候呢,
the first coming of Jesus,
我们知道整个先知书里面一直在预言说有一位弥赛亚要来。
We know all of the prophets had pointed to the fact that a Messiah was about to come.
而且整个以色列应该是神所拣选的百姓，经过了南国北国，就是两国都，南国北国都已经灭亡了。
And the people of Israel went through the history, and the northern kingdom, the southern kingdom, both have been perished by that time.
所以他们真的在期待先知所告诉他们有一位弥赛亚要来救他们。
So they were really in anticipation of this Messiah as prophesied that was to come to save them.
但是耶稣第一次来的时候
，When Jesus came for the first time,
他有没有达到犹太人的期望？
Did he meet the Jews' expectations?
因为当时犹太人的期望是他能够来战胜罗马人。
The Jews' expectations at the time was that he would come and beat back the Romans.
然后战胜这些外邦人。
And to defeat the Gentiles.
让整个犹太再一次的复活。
And to revive and renew the Jewish nation.
但是我们都知道耶稣第一次来的时候并不是一个军事性的弥赛亚。
And so we see that when Jesus came for the first time, he wasn't a Messiah in the military sense.
我最近我想很多人，尤其因为我们的背景都在美国，很多人可能知道 Chosen 这个叫做什么drama.
So since a lot of us live here in the U.S., we're all kind of have heard of or are familiar with a drama called Chosen.
这个影集拍得非常的好。
It's a very well done TV or drama series.
我看这个影集给我也有给我很多的震撼。
And I watched it and I was greatly impacted.
因为我们在读这个圣经的时候啊，有时候就是他只是把白纸黑字写出了一点当时，而且是非常非常你就是说简要的把当时的情况写出来。
Sometimes when we read the Bible, it's just, you know, words on a page, and it kind of just gives us an abstract or the grand summary of things that had occurred.
门徒心里到底是怎么想的，怎么的感受。
But what were in fact the kind of the thoughts and the heart feelings of the disciples?
我记得有一集里面就讲特别讲到有一个有有有两个这个门徒在对话。
And remember, one episode showed two disciples conversing with each other.
那时候耶稣在外面医病。
At the time, Jesus was out and about doing his miraculous healings.
一整天都在医病。
And he did that for the whole day.
那门徒就轮班的去帮助他。
And the disciples took turns to assist him.
然后没有轮到班的这些门徒就在他们的 campground, 就是他们住的附近就在那里聊天。
And so when it wasn't their turn, those disciples would just be at their campsite and just having conversation.
或者是你可以说他们在分享他们的心里真实的挣扎。
And they were sharing kind of the true struggles from their hearts.
那其中有一个就是说我从小就是锻炼我的身体。
And one disciple, I remember him saying, you know, from a very young age, I've been exercising and, you know, going for fitness in my body.
我就开始练武功，为的就是希望我长大的时候能够打败，能够帮助我们的犹太民族打败这些罗马人。
And I've been practicing, you know, the martial arts ever since I was young. And the point being that I want to defeat the Romans and help my Jewish brothers and sisters.
但是他说，当我跟了这个弥赛亚。他们相信他是弥赛亚。
And so they say, well, we believe this is the Messiah, but when I follow this Messiah,
这个弥赛亚看起来好像没有什么军事计划。
I'm seeing this Messiah, it doesn't seem like he has a military plan.
他就是整天医病赶鬼宣讲天国的福音。
He's just preaching the gospel of the kingdom of heaven, and he's healing people, he's chasing out demons, and that seems to be it.
他跟先知所预言的那个弥赛亚好像不大像啊。
He doesn't seem to be quite consistent with the Messiah that the prophets had have foretold about.
那我就记得门徒这个，我说这 drama 里，门徒就问另外一个人说：“你觉得再过五年，他就真的会，他还是会继续医病赶鬼讲天国的福音吗？还是他就真的会有什么行动？”
And so I remember watching this drama, and so the disciples were asking each other, well, do you think in 5 years he would just continue to do what he's doing currently, healing, chasing out demons, or will he have big action, big plans by the time?
所以你可以感受到当时门徒真正的挣扎。
And so you feel the true struggles of the disciples at the time.
他们要的是一位军事性的弥赛亚。
What they had wanted and asked for is a Messiah in the military sense.
那你知道这先知预言里面也是看到他是 也是一个军事性的弥赛亚。
And the prophets had foretold, in, you know, in many respects, he was supposed to be a military messiah.
所以对当时的人有一个很不解，对这些跟随他的门徒有一个不解。
And so the disciples who were following him at the time had some misunderstanding or some points of ignorance.
那当然神的意念高过我们的意念。
But of course, God's thought is higher than our thoughts.
高过门徒的意念。
And higher than the disciples' thoughts.
高过众先知的意念。
Higher than the thoughts of all the prophets.
他的确是要建立弥赛亚的国度在地上。
He was, of course, going to build a messianic kingdom here on earth.
但是万万没有想到弥赛亚要来两次，对当时的人来说。
But for the people of that era, they could not have imagined the fact that the Messiah was going to come a second time.
当然神的计划远远超过我们的想象。
God's plan was far greater than above our imagination.
并且他的弥赛亚国度的疆界跟这个影响是远远超过当时的犹太人的认知的。
The influence and the boundary of his messianic kingdom would have far exceeded what the Jews could have imagined and perceived of.
不仅仅是战胜他们当时的仇敌，他当时的敌人就是这些罗马人。
Not only was he to conquer the enemy of the time, which is the Roman kingdom,
并且他要战胜的是天上的、地下的、地底下的一切所有的。
But he was going to conquer and be victorious over those in heaven and those on earth and those under the earth.
我们在经文腓立比书第二章的时候看到这个描述耶稣。
And we see Jesus being described in the book of Philippians, Philippians chapter 2.
Jack, 我特别帮你做了 PPT 让你方便看了有一些经文。
Okay.
在腓立比书第二章的地方 讲到说他本有神的形象，不以自己与神为同等为强夺，那反倒虚己，除了奴仆的。Okay, 重点在第八节的后面。
And so, looking at this passage from Philippians chapter 2, verses 6 through 11, but the key point here is, let's take a look at verse 8.
第八节的后半，最后他说他是死在十字架上，所以神将他升为至高，又赐给他那超乎万民之上的名，叫一切在天上的、地上的、地底下的，因耶稣的名无不屈膝。
And the second half of verse 8 going on, he says, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death on the cross. Therefore, God has also highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of those in heaven and of those on earth and of those under the earth.
Yeah, so 11节讲到说, 就到那个情况是无不口称, 就天底下, 地天上的地上的地底下的没有不称没有不屈膝没有不口称耶稣基督为主的。
So at that point in time, as you can see in this verse, in verse 11, every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God and the Father. And this is every tongue, whether they are in heaven, on the earth, or under the earth, everyone.
所以神的心意跟计划里面的弥赛亚国度是远远超过当时的犹太人的想象的。
So the Messianic kingdom that God had in mind and had in his plans was far exceeding and above what the Jews at the time could have imagined.
那我们要来思考一件事情啊。
And so let's consider this.
弥赛亚国度的状况，就是说我们现在在讲说耶稣最终是会带下弥赛亚国度在地上，那这个弥赛亚国度到底会是怎么样的一个景况？
So what does this Messianic kingdom, in other words, the kingdom of the Messiah that Jesus brings down, what does it look like? What's the situation of it?
我们在 IHOP 的末世观的教导里面，这个弥赛亚国度，我们又把它叫做千禧年国度。
And we refer to the Messianic kingdom as the millennial kingdom here at IHOP.
就是在耶稣基督第二次再来之后，会在地上执掌王权一千年。
In other words, for 1,000 years, Jesus Christ, on his second coming, will reign sovereign here on earth.
那在这一千年之后，这个你若看启示录，这个魔鬼又会被释放出来。经过最后的一个试炼之后，迷惑之后，然后经过最后的炼境，全地会进入所谓的新天新地。
And so after this 1,000 years, Satan will be released, and there's a final trial. And then after which the whole earth and heaven will be purified and there's a new earth and a new heaven.
所以如果从几个有很多很多的经文来讲述这个弥赛亚国度。
So there are many verses in the Bible that refer and describe and discuss this messianic kingdom.
我们简单的只有来看几个。
Let's take a look at just a couple very simply.
以赛亚书的第九章。
The book of Isaiah chapter 9.
这个很多时候圣诞节会用到这一节。
Oftentimes we recite this verse during Christmas.
第六节跟第七节。
Verses 6 and 7.
因为有一个婴孩为我们而生。
For to us a child is born.
有一子赐给我们。
To us a son is given.
政权必担在他的肩头上。
And the government will be on his shoulders.
他名必称为奇妙测试。
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor.
全能的神，
永生的父，和平的君，Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
第七节讲到说，他的政权与平安必加增无穷。
And in verse 7 it says, of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end.
他必在大卫的宝座上治理他的国，以公平公义使国坚定稳固，从今时直到永远，这是万军耶和华的热心，必成就这事。
He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
那很明显的，耶稣第一次来的时候，这个经文到底有没有 fulfill, 有没有这个成就了？
So it's very obvious whether or not this verse has been fulfilled during the first coming of Christ.
的确有一个婴孩为我们而生了。
Indeed, a child was born for us.
但是他的政权，他的平安必加增无，他必坐在大卫的宝座上治理他的国，以公平公义使国坚定稳固。这件事情还没有发生。
But the greatness of his government and peace and reigning on David's throne and justice and righteousness, that part does not seem to have been fulfilled yet.
那这个事情什么时候会发生呢? 就是在弥赛亚国度掌权的时候。
So when will that part be accomplished and fulfilled? It is when the Messianic kingdom takes sovereignty over the earth.
Okay, 第二个经文我们看就是在诗篇的72篇。
At the second verse, let's take a look at Psalms chapter 72.
他要执掌权柄。
He will, yes, he will, he shall have dominion.
从这海到那海。
From this sea to, from sea to sea.
然后我们就看第十一节就好了。诸王都要叩拜他，万国都要侍奉他。
But let's just take a look at verse 11. Yes, all kings shall fall down before him, and all nations shall serve him.
Okay, 再看下一个经文，在撒迦利亚书的九章九到十节。
Let's look at Zechariah chapter 9, verses 9 through 10.
这里也讲到说，你的王，看哪，你的王到你这里来，他是公义的，并且施行拯救，谦谦和和的骑着驴。
And it says here, see your king comes to you righteous and victorious, but lowly and riding on a donkey.
那这个部分成就了。And
so that portion has been accomplished and fulfilled.
但是下一个部分还是还没有成就，也是在弥赛亚国度的时候要成就。
But the next portion has not been fulfilled, and it will be fulfilled during the Messianic kingdom.
最后他必向列国讲和平，他的权柄必从这海管到那海，从大海管到地极。
And indeed, he shall speak peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Okay, 所以还有很多很多的经文讲到这个弥赛亚国度的情况，但是我们就不一个一个看。
So we won't look at them verse by verse. All these verses described the circumstance that will be the Messianic kingdom.
但是有一件事情我们很清楚的就是弥赛亚国度 在地上掌权的时候，其实就是一个真正的世界大同，基督的国度全然在地上掌权的时候。And
so, when the Messianic kingdom reigns sovereign and takes dominion on earth, it will be the time when the whole world will be in one accord, and Christ's dominion and power shall reign supreme here on earth.
我相信你跟我的心里面都期待弥赛亚国度赶快降临。
And I think that you and I, in our hearts, we hope and we long for the Messianic kingdom to come and come quickly.
那弥赛亚国度什么时候会开始呢?
But when will the kingdom of the Messiah begin?
我们如果看启示录，启示录如果对我们教导来说, 其实是神在末后世代一个重要的征战计划的计划书。
And so the book of Revelations is a plan book or a strategy book for God's end time warfare.
那我们就会看到耶稣的再来是记载在第十一章的十五到十九节。And
chapter 11, verses 15 to 19 records the second coming of Christ.
Okay, 我们很快的看这个第十五节。Let's
take a look at verse 15 real quick.
第七位天使吹号。The
seventh angel sounded his trumpet.
你知道启示录里面讲到七音七号七晚。
The book of Revelations talks about the seven seals, the seven trumpets, and the seven bowls.
那最后的这个天使吹号的时候，第七位天使吹号的时候，
And so when the seventh the angel trumpeted,
就是在帖撒罗尼迦讲到说末号筒吹响的时候，
talks about this in the book of Thessalonians as well. In the end times when the trumpets sound,
天上就有大声音说。
There is a great voice of loud voices in heaven and saying,
世上的国成了我主和我主基督的国。
The kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ.
他要作王直到永永远远。
And he shall reign forever and ever.
然后接下来你就看到16节，看到他们在24章所有的都在俯伏敬拜这位神。
And so in verse 16 and onward, you'll see the 24 elders being prostrate before the throne and worshiping God.
对十七节讲到说，昔在今在的主，全能的神啊，我们感谢你，因为你执掌大权，作王了。And
in 17 is saying, we give you thanks, O Lord God Almighty, the one who is and who was and who is to come, because you have taken your great power and reigned.
Okay, 所以如果我们看这个时间点呢，
So if you look at this point in time,
弥赛亚国度什么时候会开始?
When does the kingdom of the Messiah begin?
如果就这个经文就很仔细来看，一定是在七号铜吹响之后，第七号吹响之后。
And if you kind of examine this verse closely, the Messianic kingdom begins probably somewhere after the seventh trumpet is sounded.
世上的国才会成为我主基督的国。
And only then will the kingdoms of the earth become the kingdoms of my Lord or the Christ.
所以有一个很重要的问题就要问了。我们知道说好，七号铜吹响之后，我们才会所谓 you know, 还当然那个后面还讲到七晚再，然后才会进入到所谓的基督的国度在地上的掌权。
那 So after the seventh trumpet, of course, there's the seven bowls and some tribulations, and then the kingdom of Christ will reign sovereign.
那我们现在处在什么地方呢?
And so the question for us then is, at what point in time are we?
我明显如果就这个经文来看，还没有到七号铜吹响，第七号铜吹响。
Looking at this verse very closely, we are not quite at the point of the trumpet sounding.
但是，所以因为耶稣还没有来嘛，okay.
Because Jesus hasn't come for the second time yet.
但是我个人相信，也整个在 iHub 的很多的教导，我们真的是相信很可能在我们的这个世代。
But I believe personally, and based on a lot of our discussion and teaching on iHub, we believe that it is very possible for us in this generation.
甚至就是 My Bible 常常讲说 if not my generation, 就是我的儿子的这个 generation.
Pastor Mike Bickle often says, if not his generation, but you know, it'd be maybe his son's generation.
我们应该是会亲眼看到这件事情发生。
We will be able to see this thing happen with our own eyes.
那我们这个事情到底什么时候会发生?
So when exactly will this event occur?
我在教导整个末世的时候特别一定要从一个信息开始讲，就是 what time is it?
I have to say, you know, when I teach about the end times, I begin with the question, what time is it?
那我不重复这个信息啊，这个 TV 上面有，你们可以去找。
If you're interested in looking at that message, you can search for it on Good TV.
但是马太福音二十四章是讲到末世的征兆非常重要的一章。
But the book of Matthew, the book of Matthew, chapter 24, talks about some very important signs for the end times.
然后路加福音二十一章跟马太福音二十四章几乎就是重复的一样的信息。
And chapter 21 of the book of Luke essentially repeats the same message from the chapter 24 of Matthew's.
如果看到路加福音二十一章，我们看到第十节的时候
，If you look at chapter 10 of verse 10 of chapter 21 of the book of Luke,
基本上这一段对话是什么呢？
What does this conversation refer to?
门徒跑来问耶稣说：“夫子啊，你什么时候有这些事呢？就是这些末世的事情，什么时候会有什么样的征兆呢？”
In chapter 7, the disciples were asking Jesus, "Teacher, when will these things happen, and what will be the sign that they are about to take place?"
那有很多的细节我先不讲了，但是最后他讲到说，第十节的下半他讲到说，民要攻打民，国要攻打国。
Without going into excruciating detail, the second half of verse 10 says, nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom.
地要大大的震动。
And there will be great earthquakes.
多处必有饥荒、瘟疫，又有可怕的异象和大神迹从天上显现。
Famines and pestilences in various places and fearful events and great signs from heaven.
所以我们如果从这整个经文就都是从经文上来看的时候。
And so if we look at all of these verses,
所有我们现在在经历的所谓这些震动,
all of these shakings that we are currently experiencing,
对神来说是不是一个意外呢?还是他 out of control? 哇, COVID 来了,神也 out of control 了。
Was it out of God's control? Oh, COVID pandemic came, it was out of God's control. Was it a surprise to God?
非常明显不是哦。
Very obviously not.
因为我们都还没有经历的时候，所有即将要经历都已经写在圣经上面了。
Because before it had occurred, all of these things have been written in the Bible.
那我们所有的事情，我们即将经历所有的战书都已经写在圣经上面了。问题就是我们有没有读懂，有没有读进去。
And so all of these things that we are experiencing have been already written out in God's playbook, his strategy book. And so the question, only question remains is, have we read it and have we understood it?
所以 bottom line 就是最底线我们要去问的一个问题就是我们现在到底在哪里?
And so the bottom line question for us is, at what point are we?
所以如果按照我们刚刚所一连串所看下来的我觉得很清楚地看见我们正处在一个时代。
So based on all of these things that we have just examined just now, I think it should be very clear that we are currently in this particular point in time.
这个时代就是人类历史即将有最伟大的救恩即将成就的前夕。
Which is a time during human history that is on the precipice of the greatest accomplishment of salvation.
耶稣基督即将第二次再来。
We are on the precipice of the second coming of Christ.
并且要带领全人类得救的人 of course, 就是进入弥赛亚国度全然在地上掌权的时代。
And the second coming of Jesus Christ will lead those who have been saved into the kingdom of the Messiah, in other words, into the era in which Christ's domain reigns supreme on the earth.
所以你如果用这样的眼光跟这样的一个认知来看我们所面对所有的震荡做震动的时候
So with this vision and with this perspective, let's take a look at all of these shakings that we are going through.
我们所经历的每一件事情都不是意外
All these events that we have experienced, none of them are surprises to God.
也不是我们被卡住了
And none of them are showing that we are being stuck.
当我们用神的眼光跟心意明白他的心意在做什么的时候
If we understand God's vision and if we can understand what God has in mind in his will and in his heart
我们知道我们正在进入弥赛亚国度来临之前必经的过程
And then we understand that we are on this path that has to be gone through before the kingdom of Messiah comes
所以我把它叫做进入弥赛亚国度的摇篮
And so that is why I call thisthe crib of entering into the kingdom of the Messiah.
对，弥赛亚国度正在被这些震荡的当中孕育出来。
And in all of these shakings, the messianic kingdom is being born, in the process of being born.
所以刚刚再重复讲一次说，我就非常重要的，当我们有一个转换的眼光，有神的眼光，有圣经的眼光来看所有所发生的事情的时候。
So again, I want to reemphasize, when we have a biblical viewpoint, when we have God's vision, to look at all of these things,
我们应该会有一个所谓的 paradigm shift.
That should bring about for us a paradigm shift.
那这个 paradigm shift, 我们就应该不会再 get stuck, 或者是仍然关在这个沮丧里面。
And so with that paradigm shift, we should no longer feel as if we are oppressed, frustrated, or stuck.
不只是不 get stuck, 不被卡住。
And not only are we not stuck.
其实我们应该是里面充满兴奋的。
Within ourselves, in fact, we should be excited.
我们竟然活在这样一个伟大的时代里面。
Excited for the fact that we, in fact, are living in this wonderful and great time.
所以当这个被你 要被关起来要被 做这些很多很多的调整的时候你的里面如果是跟上面对齐的时候你会知道哇这些不是对我的限制而是这些就是一个计划当中的这个摇篮要把我带进去弥赛亚国度
So when you're making all these adjustments rather than thinking you're stuck at home or you have been kind of restricted you have to think that you know in your heart you're excitedfor this time because you are in the crib that will bring about the messianic kingdom and you are going into it.
那我们的行为也需要跟他的心意跟他的计划对齐。
And so our behavior needs to be aligned as well with his will and his plan.
你知道耶稣第一次来的时候他在上十字架之前最后跟门徒交心的一段话。
And so when Jesus Christ, on his first coming, on the eve before he went onto the cross, he had a final heart-to-heart with his disciples.
我们看这个约翰福音第十六章，约翰福音第整个十三，我们最近正在讲这个十三章到十七章。
Recently, we've been studying the Gospel of John from chapters 13 to 17.
其实这个是耶稣在就是在科西马尼园之前 非常重要的一段信息。
And this is a very important message that Jesus released before the Garden of Gethsemane.
换句话说，就是他在上十字架之前，就好像对门徒挖心掏肺的，一直要告诉他们他心里面在想什么。
And in other words, this is a message that Jesus wanted to convey from the bottom of his heart to the disciples before he went on to the cross.
约翰福音第十六章的十六节。
And so chapter 16, verse 16.
他说，等不多时，你们就不得见我。
Jesus went on to say, in a little while, you will see me no more.
在等不多时，你们还要见我。
And then after a little while, you will see me.
那这个门徒就在那边彼此对说，他在讲什么啊？
And so in 17, some of his disciples were saying to one another, what is he talking about? What does he mean by this?
17到19节，他耶稣就在解释这些事情。
And from 17 to 19, these verses Jesus used to explain himself.
然后20节的时候。
But in verse 20, he says this.
耶稣说，我实实在在地告诉你们。
Very truly, I tell you.
你们将要痛哭哀嚎，世人倒要喜乐。
You will weep and mourn while the world rejoices.
你们将要忧愁，然而你们的忧愁要变为喜乐。
You will grieve, but your grief will turn to joy.
妇人生产的时候就忧愁。
A woman giving birth to a child has pain.
因为她的时候到了。
Because her time has come.
但是既生了孩子，就不再纪念那苦楚。
But when her baby is born, she forgets the anguish.
因为欢喜世上生了一个人。
Because of her joy that a child is born into the world.
你们现在也是忧愁，但是我要再见你们，你们的心就喜乐了，这喜乐也没有人能够夺去的。
So it is with you, now is your time of grief, but I will see you again, and you will rejoice, and no one will take away your joy.
最后他说，在二十三节后面他讲说，我实实在在告诉你们，你们若奉父求什么。
And in the second half of verse 23, he says, Very truly, I tell you, my Father will give you whatever you ask in my name.
你们若向父求什么，他必因我的名赐给你们。向来你们没有奉我的名求什么，如今你们求，就必得着，叫你们的喜乐可以满足。
In 24, until now, you have not asked for anything in my name. Ask, and you will receive, and your joy will be complete.
所以我看见耶稣在这一段跟门徒交心的这个话语里面呢。
And so in this conversation that Jesus conveyed to his disciples from his heart,
非常清楚。
And he made it very clear.
你们会有震动，你们会看到我上十字架，但是 that's not the end.
You will be shaken, you will see me crucified, but that's not the end.
你会知道我，你们还要再见到我。
You must know that you will see me again.
这个见到等了很久，还没有快要见到。
And so we are waiting to see him again, and not just quite.
那你知道整个人类历史，如果明白救恩的人，所有的人类历史等的应该就是这一刻。
And so if you understand human history, throughout our entire history of mankind, this is the moment we've been waiting for.
就是耶稣，他说他怎么去，他要再怎么回来。
And that is how Jesus said, the way he went, that is the way he will come again.
所以整个救恩历史最伟大的那一刻就是当那一日耶稣要驾着云再一次从天再来。
The greatest moment in history will be the time when Jesus comes down again riding on the clouds.
所以经过这个震动之后。
So after we go through this shaking.
我不知道你有没有办法想象当那一刻当我不知道什么时候但是我真的相信我们这个时代可以看得到。
I don't know the exact moment, but I truly believe our generation will be able to see it.
你能不能想象，当你的眼睛看到耶稣从天再一次降临的时候
？Can you imagine if you, with your own eyes, see Jesus coming down on the skies？
他说我们的那时我们的心会全然的喜乐。It is real. He is faithful. He has come.
他是信实的，他是完全然的，他是真实的，他来到了，我们的心会完全的喜乐。
那个喜乐是没有人能够夺去。Thank you, Jack.
No one can take that joy away.
So 到那日我们，然后我觉得他给我们一个非常宝贵的应许啊。
And so he has given us this wonderful and precious promise.
向来你们没有奉我的名求什么。
Up until this point, you have not asked for anything in my name.
如今你们求。
But now ask.
就必得着。
you will receive.
叫你的喜乐可以满足。
So that your joy will be complete.
所以这个喜乐不只是好像一个远远的抓不到的喜乐。
So this joy is no longer something that is far away that, and you seem you know, unable to grasp.
他甚至告诉你借着祷告。
And, he, and in fact, he tells you through prayer,
当你奉他的名求什么的时候,
through prayer and when you ask for something in his name,
当然不是妄求啊,但是如今你们求就必得着。
But of course, you're not asking for something in vanity, but when you ask for something in his name, now you will receive.
叫你们的喜乐可以满足。
And your joy will be complete.
所以我看到最后当耶稣跟他的门徒交心的时候,
So when I see this passage where Jesus wants to have a heart connection with his disciples,
他正面对十字架一个最困难的 assignment.
He is facing his most difficult assignment, the cross.
但是他对竟然对门徒说，那个极大的世人夺不走的喜乐，就是在会在你的心里面。
But he is able to say to his disciples, this greatest joy which the world cannot take away is in your heart.
最终后来到约翰福音第十七章的时候。
So in the end, in John chapter 17,
我们看到我不进入这第十七章了，但是整个约翰福音第十七章就是几乎就是耶稣最后的祷告了。
So we won't go into it in detail, but the whole of chapter 17 of the book of John is Jesus's final prayer.
非常非常 profound 的一章。
A very profound chapter.
讲述到我们跟神的关系。
It talks about our relationship with God.
我们跟父的关系。
Our relationship with God the Father.
原来全部都是完完全全都在他的里面，完完全全的合而为一。
We are in Him and in oneness with Him completely and fully.
我想这也是我们在这个旅程里面所经历的。
And I think that is something that we are able to experience on this journey.
所以我最后呢，我觉得要跟大家分享。
And so in the end, I want to share this with every one of you.
希望我相信在这里的家人都已经得着这个喜乐。
And I think that all of you family members here have already received this joy.
我们这一次的整个聚集有一个很重要的目的，就是我非常喜欢陈牧师所说的 ,We want to reach out, 我们要向那些孤单的麦子 来伸出我们的手。
And I like what Pastor Chan said, one of the very important goals of this gathering is that we want to reach out our hands to those lonely wheat.
我觉得有很多的人在那里等候知道这个荣耀的信息。
And I think a lot of people are there waiting to understand and know this glorious message.
那最重要的是我们这些人真正的得着。
But the most important thing is that we have to truly receive it and get it.
不是被世界的王弄瞎了眼睛。
Instead of being blinded by the king of this world.
进入沮丧。
Instead of going into depression.
我的祷告是我们真正的打开眼睛。
And so my prayer is that we can truly open our eyes.
看见圣经里面给我们何等荣耀的应许。
To see what glorious promises have already been given us through the Bible.
看见神的心意，确实的心意是什么？
And to see what truly is God's will and His heart.
当我们跟他全然的对齐的时候，
When we are fully in alignment with God.
当我们的整个perception 是跟神的这个 perception 不知道怎么翻，完全对齐的时候。
When our perception is completely aligned with God's perception,
我相信我们不是会被卡住的一群人。
I believe that we are not a people who will feel stuck.
我们不但不是这个负面的不被卡住而已。
Not only are we not stuck, kind of in a negative sense,
我相信我们这一群人要对这个世代宣告出最大的盼望。
But I believe we are a group of people who will proclaim the greatest hope to this generation. Because we will truly live out the strength of the gospel. We are in this glorious, the most glorious generation. And we are so thankful that God has selected this generation.
一起跟他推动这个震动，就是 这个弥赛亚国度要降临的这个摇篮。
To become a people who co-work with God to push through these shakings and to bring about the crib of the kingdom of Messiah.
就但愿这个信息带给大家真实的盼望。
And I hope that this message has brought true hope for all of you.
让我们都来跟他对齐。
Let us all be aligned with God.
让我们都能够一起看见他的心意。
Let us all be able to see God's heart and God's will and his vision.
我们一起做一个祷告。
Let's end in prayer.
天父，我们谢谢你。
Heavenly Father, we thank you.
谢谢你在你的圣经里面，你给我们的话语是何等的真实跟清楚。
We thank you because through the Bible, your word given to us is true and clear.
我们知道，好像我们活在一个动荡的时代。
We see that we are living in times of great shaking.
好像甚至我们如果没有把我们的 focus 放对的时候，我们很可能被这个时代巨大的摇动着。
We see that we are in times where there is great shaking, and we could be shaken if our focus is on the wrong place.
但是我们谢谢你，因为你的话语清楚地告诉我们。
But we thank you because your word clearly tells us.
你的心意和你的作为。
Your will and your actions.
我们祷告你让我们一切的我们的思维思考模式全然的跟你的话语对齐。
And our prayer is that our way of thinking and our paradigm and our behavior completely and fully align with you.
我们不仅是单单的好像觉得哦不沮丧就好了。
Not only should we feel, not depressed, we are not depressed, not frustrated.
主，我们更要成为那个带有盼望的人，去宣告这个盼望。
But more so, we become the hopeful people who will be able to declare and proclaim that hope.
我们向你说，帮助我们能够在百般的试炼中仍然大喜乐。
And we ask that you help us to have great joy through all tribulations and trials.
因为这个喜乐是有根有基的。
Because this great joy is well-founded and rooted.
知道你的国必定来到。
Knowing that your kingdom will come.
知道你的旨意必定成就在全地。
And knowing that your will be done on the earth.
再次向你感恩，选召我们活在这个世代。
We thank you again for having selected us and allowing us to live in this generation.
我们说这是一个特权，是一个 privilege， 我们向你献上感恩。
We thank you because it is a privilege, a special thing that you have given us.
我们再次说谢谢你。
Again, we say thank you.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 我们谢谢尼克牧师给我们有一个美好的分享。
We thank Pastor Nicole for giving us a wonderful testimony.
We thank you, Pastor Nicole, give us a wonderful sharing.As Nicole shared, I think one Bible verse is in Romans chapter 15, verse 4.
刚才 Nicole 牧师分享到就是很重要的。
那段圣经讲到的，从前所写的圣经都是为教训我们写的，叫我们因圣经所生的忍耐和安慰呢，可以得着盼望。那节圣经说到 ，For whatsoever things were written, 他那边 能翻译吗？
可以听见吗
？Jack， 你翻译一下可以吗？
罗马书几章？
十五章第四节。
Okay, so Romans chapter 15, verse 4 says this: For everything that was written in the past was written to teach us, so that through the endurance taught in the scriptures and the encouragement they provide, we might have hope.
忍耐和安慰得着盼望。
Through the endurance.
所以我觉得我们今天这个时代真是像刚刚尼克牧师说到，是神在一个震动的时代啊。
And indeed, like Pastor Nicole said, we are in a time of great shaking.
所以也在这个震动的时代呢，神给我们这个同行有一个家啊。
And so in this time of great shaking, God has given us a home, a journey in which we can walk together as family.
你发现人类有一个特性啊。
And we discovered this, which is that the humankind has this special property.
Most of people in the world are spectators.
世界上绝大多数人都是观望者。
So they are not either black or white, they're just gray.
So 观望者呢，就是说他既不白也不黑，他其实半白不黑的灰色。
So most of them stay in the gray area.
绝大多数人都留在一个灰色的地带。
I don't know whether you have such observation. I'm 60, almost 63. This is a very conclusive observation of my journey in the last 60 some years.
我今年快63岁，我过去60多年来这样子一个生活，我有这样一个很确定一个结论观察得出。
So you know why God shake the world?
所以你知道神为什么要震动这个世界吗？
Let people moving away from the gray area.
就让这个人可以离开这个灰色区域。
So that's why we mentioned many times the pandemic is really acceleration process in the God's prophetic calendar.
因为这个就是我们为什么在很多次都提到说这个疫情呢只是一个加速的一个过程，在神的这个预言的一个计划书中是一个加速的过程。
Because in a shaking era, gray area is no longer safe.
因为在这样一个震动的时代当中呢，灰色的地区、灰色的地带就不再是安全地带了。
So you have to choose your side.
所以你必须选边站的。
But on the other hand, God also reminds us it is not good for man to live alone.
但是呢，同一时间神也提醒我们，人独居是不好的。
That's why if you are a wheat,
这就是为什么如果你是一粒麦子，
you have to find the right group to join.
或者说你是一个稻穗，你是一个麦穗，你必须活在一个正确的群体当中。
So this pandemic is really a regrouping process.
所以同样这个疫情呢也是一个就是重新分组的一个过程。
I especially welcome everyone online. If you haven't found your group, you should find a group of wheat.
如果在线上聚集的弟兄姐妹家人，你如果还没有找到一个正确的族群的话，你必须要找到一个可以跟你们同行的一个组。
Because to nurture the lifestyle Pastor Nicole just mentioned, you need a group.
因为呢，要进入到尼克牧师刚才所提到的这样一个生活模式当中呢，你必须有一个族群，有一个组。
You cannot just solo in the shaking era.
这个震动的这样一个时代中呢，不是你单人单枪匹马可以挺过来的。
So we welcome everyone to embrace this family of God.
所以我邀请每一位来拥抱这样神的一个家。
And also can join our family journey on a daily basis.
也能够在这样一个回家的旅程当中每天的一起来参加聚集。
So we want to once again thank you, Nicole, for delivering such a wonderful sermon this morning.
所以谢谢大家，欢迎大家今天来参加，也很谢谢Nicole牧师今天。